Hare Krishna. The environment is not ours to take or leave. It is ours to make. We are living in an age of increasing environmental challenges. More and more, our indiscriminate attempts to exploit the resources of nature have contributed to disrupting natural balances and setting off extremely dangerous natural forces, which can come upon other cyclones as extremely high or extremely low temperatures, as seismic disturbances, and so forth. Some people have a very apathetic attitude towards the environment. Now, we could have one attitude towards the environment, is you think it's ours to take. That's what the attitude that dominated the capitalist and the colonial mentality, where people expanded across the forests, across the seas, to new lands, and exploited them indiscriminately. We thought it's ours to take. So whatever we want, we will do with the environment. And that is a primary cause of the disaster facing us now. Now, when faced with this environmental crisis, some people, so earlier we were apathetic in exploiting it. And now when it's our responsibility to do something to protect it, some people, instead of, we thought the environment is for ours to take. And now we think, some people think it's ours to leave. That means that I don't care about it. If I just don't care about it, nothing will happen. But we can't leave the environment. This is the planet on which we are living. And this is the planet in which our descendants will have to live. And if we soil the bed on which we are going to sleep, then we have to sleep on a soiled bed. So we can't leave the environment. This is the planet on which we have to live. And if the planet becomes polluted, if the planet becomes disturbed, then our lives will become disturbed. So the environment is not ours to leave. To leave also. We can't take it. Some people say take it or leave it. So they say if you want, this is how it is. Take it or leave it. But we can't adopt a take it, leave it approach to the environment. We can't take it for ourselves and we can't leave it. Because we have to live in it and we have to live with it. So, what can we do? We have to make the environment. We have to make the environment means we have to become conscious of our responsibility in our environment and make it conducive for our living and for our flourishing. And for this, a vision of the sacred needs to be infused in our dealings with the environment. The Bhagavad Gita explains that actually the environment is under the divine and is a gift of the divine to us. The Bhagavad Gita says that maya adhyakshena prakriti suyate sacharacharam hetunanena kaunteya jagad viparivartate. The environment which provides us so many gifts, that environment is actually under the divine. And to the extent we learn to harmonize ourselves with the divine and live a more spiritual life, to that extent we will automatically let go of the materialism and the exploitation that is harming the environment and thereby harming us eventually through a boomerang effect. So by recognizing that we can make our environment by making our consciousness divine. The more we make our consciousness divine by connecting with the divine through the process of devotion, the more we'll be able to adopt lifestyles that will be conducive to making the environment more conducive for us. And the more we see the environment as divine, the more we'll be able to also interact with it and deal with it in a way that will make it more hospitable and better for us and for our future generations. Thus, by making our consciousness, which is our inner environment, divine, we can make our outer environment also divine. Thank you. Hare Krishna.